guys, WRG Blackheart here, and today we're going to review my Xbox 360 game collection. I only have like 19. Last video, since it's been a few months since I last posted my video of my GameCube collection, I did say that I would review my Xbox 360 games sometime soon. And now here I am. Okay, let's start in alphabetical order. First up, we have Amped 3. This is the best snowboarding game ever for the 360 in 2005. However, it is rated T for teen, because it says it has crude humor, mild violence, and suggestive themes. The first two Amped games on the original Xbox were E-rated. I don't know why this is T-rated, but I know what the meaning of the rating means, but it is what it is. Okay, there we go. Next up, we have Call of Duty Black Ops 1 and 2. Okay, about Call of Duty Black Ops here. It's about you playing as Alex Mason during the Cold War and Vietnam War. It's where this game's about Alex Mason being interrogated with the numbers messing his mind up, and he met a prisoner, a Russian prisoner named Viktor Reznov. But Mason doesn't know if Reznov was either A, with him the whole time, or B, in his mind. But the main antagonist that Mason wanted to kill is Dragovich. Okay. In Black Ops 2, this game is about Alex Mason's son, David, being in the military to take on Raul Menendez's men. But back then, when David was 7, Raul used the Asian dude to set Woods up to make Woods believe that the man captured alive with the black vein on his head was Mason, not Raul Menendez. So David is avenging his own father's death and setting Woods up. And the game in this, the storyline of this game took the year place in 2025. So it wasn't Woods' fault that he accidentally killed Mason. Next up, Chrome Hounds. This is a vehicular and walking deathmobile shooting game where you choose your own vehicle on wheels or a walking robotic deathmobile to destroy enemy territory. But you have an amount of time. If you take 2 damage or waste time, you fail the mission. This is teen rated by Sega for mild language and violence. Next up, Family Guy, Back to Multiverse. It's where Stewie and Brian hunt for Bertram in every universe to hunt him down, or he'll take over the whole universe and alternate universes. Okay, next up. Okay, next up is Gears of War. In this game it's been 14 years after E-Day, where Dom rescues Marcus, escapes the prison, and takes on the Locust to retrieve the Resonator from Alpha Squad at Embry Square. But while Marcus and the others were trying to escape, Marcus saw Lieutenant Min Young Kim got slain through the stomach by the ruthless, brutish locust general named Rahm. R-A-A-M. That's how you spell him. But in the end, it was hard for me to kill Rahm, but I finally figured out a way to kill him. It's not that hard, it's just that you gotta watch out for the Reavers on each side that's blocking your way to kill Rahm, and the Krill was shielding him. And when you could throw a grenade or a torque bow arrow to aim at Rahm, and when it hits him, the Krill will be out of the way. When I killed Rahm in the game, I'm like, he deserved to die after what he did to the lieutenant. Okay, in Gears of War 2, this game is about the city sinking by Locust Force, which was a giant worm called the Ripped Worm. It sank cities, and Marcus and Baird, Dom, and Cole didn't know how many hearts were inside a worm. I'm like, you guys should know, how many hearts a worm has, like an octopus. So what I meant by that is 3. Yeah. And then they had to take out the locust leader. But they failed to attempt, and they failed to attempt to get the queen, but the queen's bodyguard / locust Cantus was named Scourge. He was like a giant, tall giant with a double-wheeled saw blade. Imagine if Scourge's death were his Hydra was killed, he flew in the air, and then bam, something pointy would stab him through. Okay, hold up. Okay, next up, Gears of War 3. 2 years after the fall of Jacinto, so it's where Marcus goes on the hunt, goes and finds his father on Azura Island in all of Sera. His father has a weapon called the countermeasure. It's where he'll use it to kill all the emulsion and the lambit without harming the locust, but he couldn't find a way to save the locust on time because Mira didn't care if Sera is dying or not, so she forced him to save the locust, but he didn't want to. But in the end, I might spoil this out, but it's sad, but Adam Phoenix didn't make it. He injected the emulsion himself to see how it reproduced. And when 3 flashes happened, his time was up. And so Marcus killed Mira and end the war once and for all. Then all the emulsion, Lambin, and Locust have died. And Anya will always be with Marcus. But Dom died in the end. I know it's sad. Okay, next up. Grand Theft Auto 4 and 5. These games were great, but I like the 5th one better than the 4th one. I haven't played the 4th one in a while. It's in this case. See? Grand Theft Auto 4. Darn, won't close. Oh well. In GTA 5, it's now the city of Los Santos, where in the beginning you really thought Michael Townley was dead, but you should know he's still alive. Hold up again. Okay, next up, the Halo games. First up, we have Halo 3, where the Chief is found in the beginning, but no sign of Cortana. Chief was planning to kill the elite called the Arbiter, but he he didn't know the Arbiter was a friendly. Then Halo 4, 4 years after Halo event, it's where Master Chief and Cortana are stuck on a planet called Requiem, and they discovered something evil beyond, in the planet's core. It was the Didact. He is a 9 foot tall monster or something. I don't know, but he is taller. Next up, Halo Reach. This is a prequel related to the first Halo game, where you play, make your own Noble Six to take on the Covenant. There's 5 members of Noble Team, and the 6th one is the Noble Six. Next up, Left 4 Dead. Left 4 Dead is a survival horror video game developed by Valve and published by Source for the Xbox and PC. It's about you fighting zombies. In this game, there's Zoe, Bill, Lewis, and Francis. But in Left 4 Dead 2, it's more advanced because it has weapons, new zombies, new characters. Yeah. And some new levels, too. I prefer both of them better because they're cool. Okay, next up, Madden 12. You know it's a sports game, but yeah, I'm not that great of it. Like, I'm not great at playing. Okay, next up, MotoGP 06. It's a good racing game on a motorbike. Okay, 2 more left. Next up is Prince of Persia, The Forgotten Sands. It's about the Prince of Persia returning home to see his brother and father. No way, I think his father was dead. But he was about to see his brother. Okay, and last but not least, Project Gotham Racing 3. Best racing game in 2005. Yep. That's pretty much it. If you guys are wondering which game is your favorite in this video, please post a comment down below. Subscribe my YouTube channel, WRG Blackheart. And don't forget my nephew Dylan's channel, The Eraser, or something. His last video was Super Dash Vlogs or Super Smash Vlogs or something like that. Anyway, I'm gonna do my original Xbox games after Christmas because I'm a little short, okay? And that's pretty much it for this video. Please like. If you dislike, don't watch this again. I'm just saying, okay? Bye.